Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. May Allah's peace and blessings be on all of you. This is the continuation of the series Fall in Love with a True Muslim. This is the third installment. For first and second, visit the links below in the description and please subscribe. Let's move on. Islam lays a great deal of emphasis not only on self-purification, but also propagating and preaching the truth to others, enjoying what is right and forbidding what is wrong. As Prophet Muhammad said, "Convey from me, even if it is one verse." So it is obligatory for all Muslims to invite others to the way of Allah. Hence, a true Muslim considers this his responsibility and is always keen to spread the peaceful message of his Lord. But the question arises, how? What are the limits? Quran answered this question in chapter 16, verse 125. Invite to the way of the Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them in ways what are best and most gracious, for the Lord knows best who have strayed from his path and who receive guidance. Wisdom is one of the hallmarks of a true Muslim. In order to invite others, a true Muslim will first strive to get the correct understanding of what he is preaching. He will seek methods which are best, beautiful, and effective. He will not show his ideas into the mind, rather he will give examples and use logic to drive home his point. Following in letter and spirit the express commandment of Allah. A true Muslim is always gracious in arguments. He knows that ultimately guidance is in hands of Allah. Choosing a proper time for preaching is essential and a crucial part, as clear from Sahih Bukhari, Volume 1, Book 3, Number 68. Narrated Ibn Masud. The Prophet used to take care of us in preaching by selecting a suitable time so that we might not get bored. Another advice regarding the methods come from the chapter 3, verse 64. Say, O people of the book, come to common terms as between us and you, that we worship none but God, that we associate no partners with him, that we erect naught from among ourselves, Lord and patrons others than God. If then they turn back, say, bear witness that we are Muslims. So the idea is to start with things common in the revealed scriptures. Starting with differences will only create confusion and conflict. So you will not find a true Muslim quarreling with others. Instead, he always adopts a soft and a gentle way. It is also imperative for a true Muslim to practice what he preaches. There should be no conflict between his actions and his words. Allah condemns such as in chapter 2, verse 44. Do you enjoy right conduct on the people and forget yourselves? And yet you study the scripture? Will you not understand? Allah instructs people to form groups of well-trained people to perform this duty of enjoying good and forbidding evil, as mentioned in chapter 3, verse 104. Let there arise out of you a band of people inviting to all that is good, enjoying what is right and forbidding what is wrong. They are the ones to attain pleasure. Provide with opportunity, a true Muslim is always eager to be a part of such a community and spend his life in such a pious, prophetic mission. As the saying goes, charity begins at home, so a true Muslim is mindful of that and does not consume all his efforts in preaching distant people. As a mother, father, wife, husband, brother, and sister, a true Muslim sees it his responsibility to first convey the message to the closest and then to others, as mentioned in chapter 9, verse 71. The believers, men and women, are protectors one of another. They enjoin what is just and forbid what is evil. They observe regular prayers, practice regular charity, and obey God and His apostles. On them will God pour His mercy, for God is exalted in power wise. Like Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, every one of you is a attendant and responsible for his company. Invitation to truth is fundamental obligation for all believers. Indeed, it is one of the traits for salvation as mentioned in chapter 103, verse 1 to 3. By time, verily man is in loss, except such as have faith and do righteous deeds, and in the mutual teaching of truth and of patience and constancy. A true Muslim knows that his responsibility is only to deliver the message. He should not feel frustrated or desperate if others don't accept his advice and mend ways. Quran relays this message again and again, like in chapter 88, verse 21 and 22. You shall remind, for your mission is to deliver this reminder. You have no power over them. And chapter 28, verse 56. You cannot guide the ones you love. God is the only one who guides in accordance with His will and in accordance with His knowledge of those who deserve the guidance. Finally, a true Muslim knows that he is strongly prohibited from forcing anyone to accept Islam. He will never transgress these limits. Quran is very clear in this regard. Chapter 10, verse 99. Had your Lord willed, all the people on earth would have believed. Do you want to force the people to become believers? And chapter 2, verse 256. There shall be no compulsion in religion. You will never see a Muslim devising crooked plan or forcing people to believe. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.
وما اختلف الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءهم العلم بغيا بينهم ومن يكفر بآيات الله فإن الله سريع الحساب فإن حاجوك فقل أسلمت وجهي لله ومن اتبعن وقل للذين أوتوا الكتاب والأميين أأسلمتم فإن أسلموا فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما عليك البلاغ والله بصير بالعباد.